3, 2, 1,
go for it. Whoa!
Today, we're using gummy bears in chemistry. And you're probably wondering, why am I so excited? That's because we're gonna be talking about the topic of solid through solid. Welcome to Impossible Science. Hey everyone, it's Jason Latimer, world champion of magic, coming to you with another Impossible Science, the show where we take impossible topics and we see if we can actually bring them to life somehow through science. Now, unfortunately, what you just saw with the gummy bears passing through the bottom of the flask, that is actually a trick, but that doesn't change the subject. Can we actually get gummy bears to pass through another object? And it turns out, it's not gonna be any object. It's gonna be a plate of metal. Okay, before we can get gummy bears to pass through a sheet of metal, I wanna go over a couple things. An endothermic process is something that requires energy to happen, usually in the form of heat. So you can think of it as ice melting into water. It requires heat in order for it to take place. Now, an exothermic process is something that gives off energy or heat. It's the exact opposite. So you can think of it as water giving off heat in order to turn into ice cubes. Now, why is that important? Because today we're gonna be using potassium chlorate. Now, this is a chemical you should not be finding at your house, by the way. This is not an at-home experiment. What happens is, if I add heat to this at roughly 673 degrees, that's the melting point for potassium chlorate, and it will actually decompose and give off oxygen, making this an example of an endothermic reaction. If I get a sufficient amount of oxygen, I can use that oxygen to react with the sugar that's in gummy bears. Now, none of us have actually seen gummy bears spontaneously ignite. That's because it's not the right percentage of oxygen in the atmosphere, nor is it the right temperature. But if I had enough oxygen and I had a high enough temperature, boom, the sugars in these gummy bears will spontaneously ignite. This endothermic reaction requires energy to decompose the potassium chlorate to give off oxygen. Now, with the elevated oxygen content, it will cause more gummy bears to melt, releasing more heat in this exothermic reaction. So you can imagine that if this was hot, gives us oxygen, this melts, gets hotter, which then gives off more oxygen, which then burns more sugar. You can understand why this could be a very violent reaction. So I looked up different melting points and found that zinc has a melting point of 787 degrees. That means it's only about 110 degrees different than the melting point from this. And I figured if we could get enough sugar and enough potassium chlorate together with enough heat, we should be able to just get these gummy bears to pass right through a solid object. So I did like all my experiments and I just contacted the Ventura County Fire Department and told them what I was gonna do so I could find a safe place to do this. And then the second thing I did was contacted Collins Key and Devan Key and said, you're not gonna believe this. I'm gonna be able to take gummy bears and we're gonna get them to cut a piece of metal.
What's up?
If you guys haven't checked out their experiments on YouTube, they do crazy stuff.
Yeah, but this is, I think, the most ludicrous thing I've ever heard. We're gonna be melting a piece of metal with a flipping gummy bear.
Yeah, what is going on?
How is that even possible?
Well, we're gonna take the sugar as fuel. This potassium chlorate, and when it gets heated up, we're gonna release some oxygen. With the heat and the fuel, we're gonna have a flame. Now, I searched all over the internet to find out the temperature of this thing.
I actually did the searching myself, and it's very hot. That's the scientific term. It's very hot.
But my guess is that it's hot enough to melt this piece of zinc.
I'm so ready. Wait, why is there a little indent in the zinc?
Okay, so when this gets heated up, it's gonna turn to a liquid.
Okay.
So rather than if we need to concentrate the potassium chlorate, which when it's heated, it'll be potassium chloride, it'll sit in the puddle, then your job is to throw those in there.
All right, I'm ready.
I thought Jason was gonna say he got mad and just punched it one day, but I think that's a better explanation.
Headbutted.
Don't make me angry.
Do not try this at home.
No. Nope.
We have our safety goggles, we have our safety gloves, and we have the permission from the fire department.
Yep.
Oh, yeah.
All right, here we go.
I'm not knowing this mix of fire.
All right, so let's get it going.
Yep, and then kind of around the edge of you said?
Yeah. Once it has to heat up to about, I think potassium chlorate is about 670 degrees, right around there. It will start to melt, so we have a lot to get through. I'll just get tilted on the side here.
Okay.
So when you're dealing with a fire, you need oxygen, you need heat, and you need fuel.
Gummy bears, in this case, are the fuel.
Okay, here we go. Now we're gonna pour this into a puddle here.
Holy cow. And it's crazy, like a moment ago it was literally just powder and now it's this boiling substance.
All right.
Blowing my mind.
Go for it. Gummy bear time.
All right, here we go. Ready?
Three, two, one.
Go for it.
Whoa!
No way!
Holy cow!
Whoa.
So here's
the thing. That looks crazy!
Whoa!
See if we can concentrate the heat. I need to get the heat to go.
And of course, like the moment the gummy bears goes in, the wind picks up too.
Yeah, right?
That looks bananas.
This looks awesome.
Holy cow.
It's at night.
No, I knocked it through. No way.
Yes. A gummy bear just did that.
That is insane.
Wow. You know, to be honest, I can't see the gummy bear anymore. It's kind of burnt, but that is crazy.
Yeah, unrecognizable.
It reduced it to carbon, oxygen, and water, actually, is in there. I wouldn't drink it, though.
Definitely.
There you have it. Gummy bears can actually cut through a sheet of metal. It's just wild. We really did get a gummy bear to cut through another object. Now, it didn't look like a gummy bear at the end of that, that's for sure. But we were able to make something impossible take place through science. And if you enjoy that idea of making the impossible possible through science, let me know. Click the like button, share the video with your friends, and make sure you let me know in the comments below if you're having fun with these goofy experiments. And until next time, stay curious, because the right question changes everything.
All right, so now it's my turn, right?
Yeah, you're heating this up. Oh, yeah. We should probably mention the safety.
Yeah.
Do not try this at home.
Yep.